I'm here at the RC show for 2018. You know what? I'm standing here. I'd have to say there, Tony, you're a Canadian icon.
Well, I don't know if I'm a Canadian icon, but I'm a very proud Canadian. Love this country. Think we should be the greatest place on earth. There should be no second, close second. This should be giving us intellectual, emotional wealth, financial wealth. We should be just the place that everybody in the world wants to be. And I think that's in the interest of every Canadian to kind of get back on track.
You know, as you've actually moderated a couple of talks here at the RC show, one of them you just did was on cannabis. This year, they're going to be legalizing recreational cannabis. What do you feel that's going to do for Canada? And not only economically, but we're talking increased taxes at the same time.
I'm not a fan of legalization of cannabis because I think we're rushing it. I think we're doing it more for our prime minister and his legacy than are we set up and ready for it. What I see so far is that organized crime, which has served this market very well, is now going to have people are going to be able to walk the streets with 30 grams, have their own little grow-ups going. So we're giving them permission to compete, and yet we're slicing and dicing it among 10 provinces and territories, each with their own set of rules, all trying to control the process. And the challenge is, if we're going to do it right. Unleash the private sector, let them create the stores, the brands, let them design the science behind it, medical, recreational. So as America opens up their borders and starts legalizing, we're going to have our next big crop. We're going to have, this is going to be our oil and our wood going forward. As it is now, all I'm seeing is, hey, it's making our prime minister look at organized crime, have absolute freedom to compete, and the people who want to get in this business, so much bureaucracy and rules that we're pouring cement at their feet.
I agree 100% with what you're just saying. You know, as we're also looking at the restaurant industry, I mean, the RC show was pointing out how there's 1.3 million people employed in the restaurant industry, something like $80 billion that it's contributing to the economy. How do you feel that the restaurant industry in Canada, is there growth for it? You know, with the high taxes, the high electricity rates, and you know, the list goes on and on.
Well, you know, first you gotta look at the consumer, where half the meals are consumed outside of the home because we're busy people. We're always on the road, we're overscheduling kids, we gotta feed people. We also have passion for food. I think sometimes we just have to escape our screens, find an oasis. So all that points is great tailwinds for the restaurant industry, because what there's no place that Canadians like to do more than go out for a meal. Now let's look at the headwinds. Incredible increase in labor costs, just hit them like a sledgehammer. Food inflation, the whole sense of the what's happening with climate change in terms of sources of food. The need to bring labor in that have shining eyes and talent, but not all of them think of restaurants as a future occupation. And then we have the grocery store saying, I'm actually tired of losing all this share. I'm going to get in meal kits. I get a home meal replacement coming to my place that looks like a restaurant. One add on top of that, how about Whole Foods and Amazon teaming up? All of this is pointing to being very competitive, thin margins. You're going to have one or two competitors. You're going to have people that make things happen, capitalize on that consumer demand. You're going to have a lot of people that watch it happen because they can't make their way through those headwinds.
I think one of the biggest questions I want to ask you right now, because you've been on radio, you've been on, you know, TV, and the list goes on. What about, why can't we break down the trade barriers within Canada rather than worrying about free trade with other nations?
You know, we operate as silos. We've created this these provinces, and everybody says, who's got influence, who's got authority? Everybody wants to champion. We're so over-governed in this country, from, you know, from the mayor to you get to the, you know, municipal, provincial, federal. For 36 million people, we have so many handlers, people making laws. Very, I don't know of one person in the country that's responsible for breaking laws in terms of getting rid of the bureaucracy. So until we do that, until we say, let's act in the collective interest of the nation versus the individual interest of the province, or even worse, the self-interest of people, we're going to be buried in bureaucracy and cement, which is a shame. Our resources, one-fifth of the world's fresh water, our literacy rate, sharing a border with the United States, there should be no close second. What now is we're becoming a distant in terms of a world competitive power.
Getting back to the RC show, you know, I want you to share what does RC show say to you?
You know what I love about this industry? It's about putting smiles on people's faces. You know, there's so much passion. You walk through here, there's people, whether they're selling chef knives, whether they're involved with cleaning kitchens, uniforms, new cocktail menus. You know, we just tasted some vegan ice cream that was delicious. Everybody's involved with the experience and making it happen. Everybody has a sense of empresario. It's almost like that purpose trumps profit. And if they do it and they keep that smile going, they eke out a profit. So I love the fact that it's gone to this blue collar industry, but it also gives back about $300 million to charity. So it's not only just purpose, internal purpose, but they play a real purpose in the lives of a lot of Canadians.
Well, one of the talks that you were on, I noticed that you're on stage with John Taffer.
Yeah, well, John Taffer is unplugged. I mean, his TV personality yells a lot. I'm not a fan of reality TV. Like, people just come in and yell and scream. There's like a train wreck record. And I was hoping he'd be a little calmer. There's some things he said that were very good about relevance, about not making excuses, about having to make things happen versus wonder what happened. And there was part of his show that I don't think he can turn off. So I'm glad we saw 20 minutes. And out of that 20 minutes, we got 7 minutes of great content, 13 minutes of a lot of foam coming out of his mouth. But that's entertainment, right? You got to take the good with the entertaining.
Well, that's one great thing about, you know, reality TV is it, you know, it just entertains us. And, you know, as we're actually 2018 RC show, it's coming to wraps right now. What would you like to see happening in, you know, in 2019?
I think we're going to see a lot more thought leadership. I think last year we tested it. This year we started to perfect it. And I think what we saw at Breakfast of Champions and our thought leadership, Profit from the Profits, we saw an appetite. People want to know, man. They want to know where to go. Where am I going to put the chips on the table? Is it digitizing my kitchen and my front of the house? How am I going to attract labor? What kind of food should I be doing? All these new Canadians coming. How do I make sure I'm relevant to them? Lots of conversations, some answers, a lot more of the onion to be peeled back. And I think that's what both this association, this conference is all about.
Thank you so much for your time, Tony.
Thank you. Great to have you. Good stuff.